one of the surprise teams around the NHL coming into tonight with a 5-game winning streak. And they're going to face another team who has exceeded expectations this evening in the Montreal Canadiens.
Very solid in the defensive zone, too.
Boychuk slaps it to the wall, looking for help from Clutterbuck and Ross Johnston. Islanders come up with it. Cizikas in front. Johnston's pass behind him, but it comes to Pellick. And that one hit a body and then dropped into a dangerous area. And it winds up in the net. It rested momentarily on the head of Kotkaniemi before dropping right at the feet of Casey Cizikas. And the second try from Cizikas goes through. It's his fourth goal of the season. Now Clutterbuck putting the pressure on Riley. Moved over, and it's Domi in for Montreal. For Drouin, and his shot, he scores! Jonathan Drouin under the glove of Grice. And the Habs come right back to tie it at one.
Domi lays it into the hole. And with his speed, Drouin's able to drive through and pick the corner. A nice shot. Thomas Grice is in good position. That just, you know, every once in a while, they're going to get a goal scored on you because the shooter wins the battle.
And Andrew Ladd trying to chip it past Ben. And now it's Komarov stealing it away. He's got Filppula in a two-on-one. Komarov, Filppula scores! Komarov and Filppula hook up on the two-on-one, and the Islanders take the 2-1 lead.
And that pass is in a little tight, but he makes absolutely no mistake. So the third line, if you will, combines for a huge goal.
Chugging around the offensive zone. Slips it down into the corner. Boychuk pokes it into the skates of the referee. Goes digging for it as well. Freed up for Jordan Eberle. Back out for Pellick. Quick shot. Tipped on goal by Beauvillier, and Niemi left it for a moment.
He's disappointed that Carey Price has not been in the net because he seems to have an awful lot of luck. But a good try there by Beauvillier on the deflection against Niemi.
And then Boychuk takes it away from Matthew Pekka. Kicks around for Cal Clutterbuck. Back to Cizikas. In across the line. Johnston to the net. Cizikas, it came back too many scores! Second goal of the first period for Casey Cizikas.
Niemi is reacting to the pass, Brendan, so he starts to slide to his right, and that pass goes right back to Casey Cizikas. He says thank you very much, and now he's got two, and he'll be looking for the three.
Armia was met by Beauvillier. Now it's Letty. Lost the puck. Kotkaniemi steps out, steps in front. Grice challenge, makes the save off a skate. Open net, jammed wide by Lehkonen in tight.
Yeah, his dad did a whole lot of that. One of the tougher guys in the entire National Hockey League. He did tell me why his son is wearing 13. This shouldn't really come of any surprise. Matt Sundin was his man.
Barzal was robbed by Niemi as the puck popped right to him in the circle.
Golden opportunity. It looked like Barzal didn't really get it where he wanted to aim it. I mean, I think that was going to miss on the far side.
Get it on goal, and it's Gallagher racing back towards the Islanders' end. Mayfield kept it along the boards. Hickey came over to help. Gallagher in there. Deneau diving for it. Down goes Komarov. Picked up by Tatar. Steer to the line. Ouellette with a shot, and that one swallowed up by Grice.
There's a real good job by both Hickey and Mayfield as they blocked out the two forwards, Deneau and Gallagher. So Thomas Grice had a real good look at it outside the dots the whole time. Some point shots, Brendan, but the Islanders were there in position. Great job of penalty killing by Cizikas, that even when he didn't have a chance to score, he didn't throw it out blindly. He ate it.
Philip Deneau with an open look in there, as he has been, is Thomas Grice.
Not many guys can whistle a puck hard enough outside the dots, and look at the angle. I mean, Thomas Grice has got it. He's big enough. He doesn't give up a whole lot to shoot at. So a real nice save. Take away that potential pass. And Mete did a real nice job. Great read on his part.
Lehkonen forced it towards the goal. And Hickey forced him against the boards. And a penalty here coming against Scott Mayfield as he got a stick in the skates of Kotkaniemi. Second power play for the Habs. Both of them coming here in the last few minutes. Jonathan Drouin moves it on the boards for Domi. Domi has Gallagher in front. He loads. He shoots. They score. Max Domi with no vision for Thomas Grice, thanks to Brendan Gallagher. It's a power play goal, and it's a one-goal game.
I don't check to see if there was any goaltender interference, but that's just Gallagher providing a really good screen. Thomas Grice is looking on the left side, and that puck basically goes on the right side.
Here's Drouin out high. Third power play of the period for Montreal. There's a wrist shot off the post. It came sailing in from Petrie. Beat Grice, found iron. A couple of Habs in his way. Dishes for Barzell. Bailey, the option all the way across as Barzell takes a step to the net and then goes out high for Letty. Letty drags back to Barzell. Eberle on the goal line. Eberle has Lee in front. They let him walk out. The save was made and it's cleared away by Niemi. He's alone and he's going to try and take it to the net. And that one kissed off the crossbar. Stayed in play and back in is Tatar with a step. Johnston hustling back to apply some pressure. And Grice makes the save as Ross Johnston chats things over with Tatar.
Drouin with the good speed, little knuckleball, and just catches the almost the corner of the net. And there's that little play through the neutral zone of transition, but Thomas Grice is in good spot.
Off the bench, it's Drouin. Drouin tries to go through Mayfield, and he did enough to separate Drouin from the puck. Off the wall, right to Domi in the slot. Beauvillier was right there. Then it's Mete, back door, and shot wide by Drouin, who had the entire net to pick from.
Yeah, that should have been a tie game for the Montreal Canadiens. They have really put a lot of pressure on the Islanders.
Out of the zone, but brought right back in by Montreal. Adam Pellick got there ahead of Joel Armia. Armia ran Pellick off the puck, and then shoveled up the boards by Kotkaniemi. Juulsen, that one tip scored! And it's Jonathan Drouin who eventually gets it.
It's just good hard work by the Montreal Canadiens. Shot wasn't blocked, just gets enough of it. Lehkonen shoots it over the, deflects it up over the shoulder.
And Eberle, Beauvillier waits and shoots and didn't get a lot on it.
Just kind of ran out of real estate as Ouellette played it well.
And now the Habs have a 2-on-1. Tatar with Gallagher. Tatar drags himself open and Grice makes the stop. Barzell helped it ahead to Beauvillier. Islanders will get the rest of that change as Beauvillier goes to work. Lehkonen drives him into the end wall. He goes down, puck under there somewhere. It rolls to the front and they get a quick whistle. Anthony Emmy never had it covered, but the referee lost sight of the puck and they're trained to, when they lose sight of the puck, to blow it down. Bouncing puck back to Bailey, spun across the ice, Barzell with five. Barzell looks at the clock, 3 seconds and two. Eberle to the front of the net, overtime coming up tonight. Trying to find a way to get it to Matt Barzell. Instead, it's Gallagher breaking through to the net. Letty came over and feeds Barzell, who overskates it, and Gallagher collects it for the Habs. Petrie from the circle with a shot. Grice to save, no rebound. A minute 28 to go. The puck comes to Kotkaniemi with 9 seconds to go. Letty backpedaling. This one airborne into the Islanders' end. Petrie and Letty lock up with two. And we will take this one the distance as the Islanders and Habs will settle it in a shootout. And the first attempt on the year for Tomas Tatar. Slows up, lost a handle, gets it back, goes to the backhand, and Grice makes the save and gets barreled into.
Matt usually likes to go to the backhand when he has the breakaways. We'll see what he does here.
Here in the fourth round against Antti Niemi, Barzell in deliberately, stays with the forehand, and Niemi stayed with him. Well, it's his fourth year in the NHL, and it's his first career shootout attempt. Fifth round and a chance to win it for Armia. And he scores. Rips it past Thomas Grice, and Montreal down 3-1. Wins it 4-3 in a shootout and stops the Islanders' win streak at 5.
And he just snapped that puck, and Thomas Grice had no opportunity at all. And it's going to be a disappointing loss of a point, Brendan, for the Islanders, who got a lead and then let it slide away and really didn't have a very good period.